In addition to 130 journalists killed within the last 3 months, other pro-Palestinian journalists have been detained by Israel for weeks and subjected to degrading treatment and torture. Despite shadow bans and censorship, Palestinians and allies have been able to document atrocities in Gaza. Most world leaders and governments have condemned Hamas' 7 October attack and the killing of civilians, but too many in the West have ignored Israel's brutal assault on Gaza, where around half the population are children. Israel's unprecedented air and ground offensives has killed more than 22,000 Palestinians and wounded more than 55,000 others. The war has sparked a humanitarian crisis, with a quarter of Gaza's residents facing starvation. More than 8,000 children have been killed, and 2.3 million Gazans have now been displaced by Israeli war. Israel's strategic relationship with the United States, a superpower and permanent member of Security Council with veto power, encouraged the former to pursue aggressive and expansionist policies and practices in the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. Today's South Africa's 84-page filing says Israel's actions are genocidal in character because they are intended to bring about the destruction of a substantial part of the Palestinians in Gaza. We must never see the SouthAfrica we saw during Holocaust again. No one has eternal mandate to play a forever victim card, especially when they've got a strong case to answer about the genocidal character of their doings in Gaza.